It's that time again. It is Water Cooler Wednesday.
That it is. Here today, Michelle Lewis from FM 100, the voice of the Grizzlies, Pete Pranica, and our very own Todd Demers. Hey, guys. Welcome. Good to see you all.
Good morning.
Pete, a little round of applause here. He's the rookie.
Go easy on Pete.
Right, let's break him in right now. Renowned physicist Stephen Hawking joined a Russian billionaire to launch a major new effort Monday to search for aliens. The pair plans to spend $100 million looking for extraterrestrial life, but is it worth that? Secondly, a big part of the project is a contest to develop the message to send aliens if they're found. So, Michelle, what do you say about this? Is there a need for us to do this?
We have always wanted to know, have we not?
Yeah.
And he's fronting the money, so go ahead.
What would you want to say?
Let's be friends.
I
want to meet them. I want to interact. So, I mean, it's not our money.
I like
it. Go for it.
How about you, Pete? What do you think?
I think any time that a civilization wants to expand its knowledge, whether it's in the ocean, near Earth orbit, on land, or deep space, I think it's a great thing. And again, it's not public money that's being used. Mm-hmm. What I really like about this is that they're going to involve a lot more people leveraging social networks. Mm-hmm. So anytime you can generate a little bit more brain power, I think it's a really good thing. And as far as what I would say to the aliens, Voyager 1, Carl Sagan and his wife put together a recording years and years ago. And basically, it's a greeting of peace. I would do it in different languages. And I'd send along some classical music or music that is germane to different cultures.
I like All it. Right. I thought you were going to say, go Grizz.
I don't know that aliens would be able to resonate with that. Maybe not.
That'd be interesting. All right, Todd, what about the need for making first contact out there?
I think these guys are nuts. Well, first of all, you're right. It's their money. It's public.
Yeah.
I mean, these guys are billionaires, and so this is probably like this much of their life savings, this $100 million. I guess I see that money and I go, wow, there's so many other things that we need right here, right now on Earth that would go even better. But you're right. It's their money, so they can do what they want. And I don't know. You'd have to learn to communicate with them before you could even communicate a message.
Good point.
I should have known better. Thank
Live
you.
Long and prosper.
Also, better for them, better for us to find them than for them to find us.
Exactly. Yeah.
Maybe they've solved all the problems that we could spend the money solving. So we just ask them. We get it
That's
done.
That's another good idea.
It's a twofer.
We'll keep it moving here.
All right. Well, BuzzFeed polled more than 100,000 parents to find out when they think kids should be allowed to do certain things. So we're going to run down a few of them. So short answers only because we want to get through. First up, get a social media account, Michelle.
Teenager.
They've already started that between about 10 and 15. The whole goal here is make sure that you're monitoring the situation and growing with them so they know the pitfalls and what to
do. In other words, he's a patsy.
Exactly.
He let him do it.
All right, Pete, get a cell phone.
Get a cell phone, I would say 13. Yes.
13?
Okay.
The patsy.
They all have cell phones, and it probably started closer to 10 or 11.
Spoiled. 13 and only for emergencies.
Okay. You don't have kids, do you?
Absolutely.
I can tell. Stay home alone, Todd.
Ooh, that one's a little bit more tricky. I'm going to go with about 14 or 15.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I was going to say 15. That's about the right age, in my opinion.
Wow.
I was going to say about 15 so they can deal with an emergency if something goes wrong in the home.
There's a level of maturity I think you get between 13, 14, 15.
But that does vary, right?
It does per child.
Boys, 18.
21.
All right, what about the issue of wearing makeup?
Oh, I'm so happy that I let Mama take care of this one.
I want to see what Daddy has to say about that.
Yeah, well, I don't like extreme makeup. I mean, light makeup, I think there's experimenting. I think girls really like to get into this, and that's fine. But if you go crazy with this stuff, Daddy's going to step in. So as long as you're being kind of cool about it, I'm all right.
Maybe lip gloss, something like that.
A little eyeliner and stuff like that.
Eyeliner, okay.
I say 13, 14. That's about the time I did it. Mm-hmm. I turned out okay, I think.
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And your makeup looks great, too.
Thank you.
It does.
Your makeup looks really nice too. So I don't know when you start.
Thank you. That's always something when I go to the department store and I ask for makeup. And they said it's so nice of you to get it for your wife.
It's for me.
Yeah, and I didn't start wearing makeup until I was close to 30. I would say early teens. And again, to Todd's point, you just kind of modulated that it doesn't go way over the top, but you experiment and kind of find what's comfortable.
Okay. What if they wanted to dye their hair?
Ooh, we've been running into that problem lately ourselves.
Because it's a new trend.
It is.
Todd, are you going to need the sofa to yourself?
I've got three kids right here in that age group that's just right there. We're battling with that, but I think closer to 15.
Hmm. I say high school.
Oh, wow.
Any high school age.
And you better check with your high school to make sure they allow it before you allow the kids to do it.
I would agree with Michelle. I think once you get into high school age, but again, you need to have a conversation about it. Just don't send them off to the salon and let them experiment.
And who's paying for it, too? That'd be my conversation. Get a tattoo, Michelle.
21.
Oh, okay. Pete?
At least 21. not when you're living in my roof.
There you go. I was about to say never. But I suppose once you become 18 or 21 and move out of the house, then you have your own choice. But I'm not real big on tattoos.
All right, now this is going to take you back a little bit. What about going to see an R-rated movie?
Oh, there's rules for that. 17.
Pete?
Simple.
Yeah, I'm always been a rules guy.
Me too.
So, okay. 17 or...
We're so boring.
I think it goes oftentimes by content. There are some things that I really don't like and I would not want my children to see. Then there's some other movies that if mom or I have seen them and we go, you know, my child's old enough to handle that and I will go with them on this particular movie, that's okay. But I agree. You want them to be 16 or 17. They rate it those ways for a reason.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. Get the sex talk. Todd, let's go ahead and start with you.
Okay. Well, you know, we're right there in that age right about now, and I'm thinking anywhere between 13 and 15 is great, but if the opportunity comes even earlier for that to happen, it needs to happen, I think, as soon as possible. And I just think we were talking cell phones and all this with all the technology. I think kids are getting smarter and learning more and finding more information sooner, so it's even more important for us to get there and make sure they have the right information.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Couldn't agree more. I was going to say 12 or 13. Kids are absolutely... a lot quicker these days, and if they're not going to hear it from you, they're going to hear it at school or from someone else. So 12 or 13 would be my gut instinct.
Got you, Pete. You're nodding your head.
I would agree. I mean, as a parent, you want to get ahead of the curve, make sure that they get the appropriate information at the appropriate time, rather than getting it from, you know, some kid at school that, you know, Lord only knows what they're going to find
out.
These days, 12 might be a little late for that, I'm just thinking.
You guys have kept it interesting for us. We appreciate it.
We try.
We now know we don't want Pete and Michelle as parents. They're not going to let us do anything.
I got time. My dad was a cop.
All
what
right.
do you expect?
Guys, thanks so much. All right, coming up next right here on Live.